From prepare, it goes to review. And this is where we have SPbinder, which is an electronic work paper system that is custom tailored or bespoke for source document-based engagements. What I mean by that is when most people think about a binder software or engagement software, you know, they might think of softwares like Pro System Engagement, Caseware, UltraTax Engagement, things like that. Those are electronic work paper systems that are for trial balance-based engagements, meaning, you know, at the core of those work paper systems is a trial balance program that sucks in accounts and then breaks up those accounts into different work papers or lead sheets like cash, receivables, etc., and then provides functionality around those work papers for reviewing them and so on. Those types of engagement systems, if you try to use them on source document-based engagements where there's no trial balance, like 1040s and 1041s, it's like trying to fit a square peg through a round hole. You end up just doing tons of workarounds, and you end up expending a lot of effort to try to have the benefit of an electronic work paper system. So a source document-based engagement binder, instead of having a trial balance at its core, it has an OCR system at its core so that scanned documents can come into it and get broken up for work papers, for wages, interest, dividend, etc. And then around those images, it provides, you know, all of the work paper preparation, review, tick marking, etc. functionality that would be important for those types of engagements. A lot more benefits in terms of automating the review of these returns compared to trying to use a trial balance system, or compared to trying to just have separate PDF and Excel files and so on. You wouldn't do that for an audit. It's for source document-based engagements. It's no more efficient to just have a document management bucket with a bunch of different files in it. So I start off looking at this binder. I see that I have an index tree. And in the index tree, I've got some documents. So you'll see these PDF icons. Here's the questionnaire that was answered in TaxCaddy. That's already indexed for me. I've got some source documents. And here you can see that there are stamps that show what data was exported to the tax return, so like tick marks. And you'll notice that in the tree, there's a bunch of these, what we call missing item placeholders. They're like outlines of documents, like dotted outlines of documents. So this shows you what they had last year, what was in the pro forma, and therefore what is still missing. Now, if you're using TaxCaddy, then of course your clients have that document request list and know what's still missing. But not all of your clients will use TaxCaddy. Now, we've seen really excellent adoption rates. We've seen that on average, a firm who invites, let's say, 100 clients in year one to use TaxCaddy will have anywhere from 30 to 40% adoption in year one. So, you know, that's in year one better adoption rates than online organizers got in over a decade. So, you know, it is really proving itself out to be something that taxpayers choose to use, but you're going to have ones that don't. More and more every year, more will. But you'll always have the ones that are going to still send you the paper and so on. How do you let those ones know what's missing? Well, there's some nice features here. I can see a summary of all of my missing documents. If I expand this, you know, I can see all the various missing documents. And I can add these as what we call missing item notes. And that creates these missing item notes that you see down here in the note pane. And with one button, I can click this email button, and they're all listed in an email. So I can send as a very first step. I can go ahead, and if my client's not using TaxCaddy, send them a list of all the documents that I'm still waiting on from them. Now, you saw here that documents like this W-2, that OCR red, those are already indexed in the index tree. But there are documents that are not red yet, like, you know, what we call non-standard documents, which are documents that OCR is not designed to recognize. And so for those types of documents, you can go ahead and just drag and drop them into the tree. If it's a pro forma item, there will already be a placeholder for them. And they just drag and drop like that. And you can go ahead and, you know, just see, just put them where they need to go. Maybe there's additional documents that you need to put in the binder as well. like an Excel file or something that you're doing. So one difference with this binder is it's not like Acrobat where it's just essentially a PDF file. You can put Word files, Excel files, emails. So I'm going to just drag and drop this Excel file in the binder. And you'll see that it will get added. And once it does, I can go ahead and associate the Excel file into the tree just like any of the other documents. So this Excel file you'll see has, I'm going to go ahead and close the note panel so we can see a little bit more of the screen, has three sheets to it. And this is a live file. It's you know, linked. I can go ahead and I can link from one sheet to another. If I change numbers, the formulas update. But each sheet is listed as a separate work paper, just like if I were to print these out to paper and I could put them wherever I want in the file. I too here can drag and drop these any part of the tree I want. They don't have to stay together. So I'm going to go ahead and drop two of them to Schedule C. I'm going to take one of them and put it in medical expenses. I'll drag and drop it into medical expenses there. And so what you see now is that I've got one Excel file that has three sheets, but those three sheets are spread out across different parts of the work papers, wherever it makes sense from a review perspective to look at them. Now, once I have these documents in here, I can go ahead and use the types of features that I would be, let's say, used to using in Acrobat, meaning I have various stamps that I can use, and this is just some of them. There's all sorts of different stamps that can be used here, but these stamps are not just for PDFs. They can be used in Excel files. They can be used in Word files. So it's like if I had printed everything to paper and I had a pencil and I could use it, whatever the document is, same thing. That's what these tools are. I can use them across any of the work papers. Another thing that I can do is I can create cross-references. And, I want to point out that the purpose of the cross-reference is really to reduce review time. I talked about how most of our clients use a leverage model where a junior person prepares and a senior person reviews. Sometimes people say, oh, why place a cross-reference? It adds more time to preparation. But the basics of a leverage model is that if you can add time to preparation but reduce it from review, that's a profitable trade. We didn't make that up. That's been the standard for decades. All we're doing here is creating really easy tools to allow a preparer to assemble a file that will be quick to review. So for instance, if I want to go ahead and cross-reference this amount to an amount on another page, I can do that. You see it was just a very easy click, and I can go ahead and I can click from PDF to PDF, from PDF to Excel in this case. If I want to take an amount here and cross-reference this amount to something on the following page, I can do that too. So you'll see here I have Excel to Excel, PDF to PDF. And let's say you're looking at a page and you say, I want to know what's on the other side of the cross-reference, but I don't want to have to switch views. I can open cross-references in a different window. And so in this case, it opened it up in my other monitor. I'll drag it over. But you see here, I can go ahead and I can drill down through these cross-references, kind of like opening a browser hyperlink in another tab. And that just opened up a third window. So you can see here how I can trace back numbers. And then once I look at them, I can go ahead and I can sign them off. So I'll say, okay, that looks fine. I'm going to sign these off and I'm going to close it. When I sign off these pages, you'll notice it takes me to the next page. So I'll go back. That's because I have the set to move to the next page when I sign off. So I save a click of not having to click next page. But when I sign it off, it's going to record who signed off and when. And this is going to, allow me to know what I've looked at, know what I haven't looked at. And also, let's say someone changes something after I've looked at it. So I'm going to go ahead and make a change to this Excel file. And you'll notice that I get now a warning symbol here that tells me someone modified this after the sign off. If I go into my review tree, and I go and I want to take a look at what's been signed off and what hasn't, You can see that items that are in black haven't been signed off. In green, they have. Green with an exclamation mark says that it's been modified after my sign off. So when you think about a reviewer who reviewed this file a few weeks ago or maybe a few months ago, and now they're in extension season, and they just want to know, you know, what's new that I haven't looked at, or has anything changed? This is a very quick way for that reviewer to get to the bottom of that without having to try to reacquaint themselves with the whole file. Just a couple more things that I would like to show you before we move on. But we are running out of time, like I told you. There's just so much functionality that we're trying to squeeze into this 1 hour. You can go ahead and run tape totals with some very unique functionality. So let me find a document here with some numbers. I'll just use this one for now. It could be any document. I'm going to open up the calculator. And you guys are familiar with the features of a calculator tape. Here's an OCR calculator. I can go ahead and I can highlight amounts that I want to read, and notice that those amounts get added up here. You see they're listed right there. And as I go through, the amounts don't need to be just on a PDF. I can add that amount from an Excel file. So I can essentially go through and create a tape. And I'll even add this amount. And you'll see it recommends what the amount is. If it didn't read it, it read it right. So, when I'm all done, I'm going to say okay equals, and I'm going to create the tape, and I'm going to give this tape a name. I'm going to call it miscellaneous expenses. And so this tape now. I can put the total of it. I'll put it right here. And so this, if I want to know, if I see this tape total, and I can give this tape total a name, notice when I put my mouse over, it tells me that it's miscellaneous expenses. And if I want to know what makes up this amount, I can go ahead and I can click through each of these items for tape one, and I can have multiple tapes. So this is also a really great tool for preparers to make it super easy for reviewers to know where amounts are coming from. If I want to edit this tape, no problem. I can go in here, I can delete amounts, change amounts, insert rows, and it's going to update the total that you saw on that document where I had this total here will get updated as I edit the tape. One last thing before I go into the deliver phase. If we go back and we take a look at the notes, you'll notice that there are a lot of different types of notes that can be placed on the document. So I'm going to add a note here. And when I do, you'll see that this is customizable. I can create a permanent note that'll roll forward from year to year. I can create a review note. And so these notes can be created. And when I create the note, I can link it to as many documents as I want. Maybe the note relates to 10 different document types, including an Excel file. And so I can go ahead and I can link this document wherever I want to. This note, I should say, wherever I want to. And when the reviewer comes and looks at it, they'll see that there's three different work papers that it relates to, and they can go and they can click on each one and see it. They can respond to it. They can clear it. And these notes are not just like comments in Acrobat or in Excel. These can be governed by role-based security, meaning that I can set it so that a preparer can't delete or clear the note of a partner. Only a partner can review or clear the note of another partner. So, you get that type of controls that you wouldn't get if you're just using comments in a document.